Health and Allied Sciences and the Department of Hematology and Blood Transfusion. I will present to you my research project titled Using DNA Testing for Precise, Definite and Low-Cost Diagnosis of Sickle Cell Disease and Other Hemoglobinopathies. I will take you through the background, objectives, methods, research conclusion, and finally the acknowledgement. Globally, it is estimated that 300,000 babies are born with sickle cell disease annually, with the majority of these babies being born in sub-Saharan Africa, and it's where the mortality of babies before the age of 5 is estimated to be as high as 58%. And Tanzania is the fifth country in the world with the highest sickle cell disease birth prevalence, with an estimation of baby being born with a sickle cell disease to be 11,000 annually, and without the proper diagnosis and management, 50% or more of this baby may die before the age of 18, with the highest mortality being under the age of 5 years old. To reduce the burden of sickle cell disease, there were various initiatives that were introduced to reduce the mortality and morbidity that occurred due to the sickle cell disease, and of those initiative, one was establishment of newborn screening for sickle cell disease with the aim of screening newborn at birth, and the newborn who were found to have sickle cell disease were immediately enrolled in a comprehensive care, and it's where the management and monitoring of this patient were followed up closely in order to reduce the pain crisis and also to improve the quality of life of patients with sickle cell disease. But also there were introduction of education to parents and caregivers who are responsible for taking care of children with sickle cell disease, with the aim of improving the awareness and knowledge regarding sickle cell disease, the manifestation of sickle cell disease, but also on how to manage and take care of the children who have sickle cell disease. But also there were community engagement and awareness regarding the sickle cell disease to provide knowledge to community regarding the disease itself and how the disease is inherited, and to remove the myth that were that occurred due to sickle cell disease. On my right hand side, the first baby that was diagnosed with sickle cell disease in Tanzania in 2015 at Temeke Lethal Hospital through the newborn screen service that they are currently ongoing. Despite the various initiatives that were put in place to reduce the burden of sickle cell disease, unfortunately, no country in Africa has successfully established a newborn screening as a universal national health intervention. This is mainly due to the cost and complex logistics of the currently available services, and also the diagnosis of sickle cell disease in a certain cases, such as sickle cell disease that occur together with thalassemias, requires DNA analysis, which is currently very expensive. In order to address one of the challenges that faces or hinders the establishment of newborn screening as a universal national health intervention, we thought on developing a precision mobile DNA technology that will be able to diagnose the sickle cell disease and other hemoglobinopathies, with a specific aim of testing the performance of the assay on DNA from both whole blood sample and dried blood spot samples, but also to compare the nanoforming ion analysis test with the conventional screening diagnostic method, that is isolytic focusing, high performance liquid chromatograph, and Sanger sequencing. We conducted our study at two hospitals. One was Temeke Lethal Hospital, and this hospital is currently conducting a newborn screening for sickle cell disease and other hemoglobinopathies. And Mwimbili National Hospital is actually the hospital that conduct sickle cell disease clinic every week in Tanzania. And our study design was retrospective and cross-section. Our study populations involved 18 newborns that were delivered at Temeke Lethal Hospital and 18 adults who attend a sickle cell disease clinic at Mwimbili National Hospital. And we use the convenient sampling as our recruitment method. We grouped our sample into two cohorts, the validation cohort and discovery cohort. In validation cohort, we involved 15 samples. Five were from dried blood spots that come from newborns, and six were pull blood samples that come from adults who attend sickle cell disease clinic. And this sample from validation cohort were previously sequenced by Sanger sequencing in order to confirm the beta thalassemia and also to confirm some of claim of sickle cell disease carrier patient who claim to have symptom of patient who has actual sickle cell disease. And discovered cohort involved 21 samples, 9 were dried blood spot samples from newborn and 12 were whole blood sample from adult. And this sample were not previous screen sequenced by any sequencing method. In this research, we use the Oxford Nanopore technology as our precision mobile technology of choice. And the Oxford Nanopore technology is a sequencing technology that enables the direct real-time analysis of a long DNA by monitoring the changes to an electrical current as a nucleic acid passes through the protein nanopore of the flow cell. In sequencing and analysis, presented before, our samples were previously screened for Sanger sequencing, especially in validation cohort, and for both samples in validation cohort and discovery cohort, were processed for full body picture and isolated focusing and HPLC, and their results were recorded in our database. And after that, from whole body sample, we separated the buffer coat and stored it at minus 80 for further analysis. And during the DNA extraction, we extracted our DNA from both buffer coat and dried blood spot by using the Kyamp DNA blood mean kit. And the DNA concentration was quantified by using the qubit 3.0 fluorimeter. And we used both assays, broad range assays and high sensitivity assays for measuring our DNA concentration. And after quantifying our DNA, then we proceeded to amplifying our target gene, which is beta globin gene locus, and this was done by using the modified primer with attached ONT barcoding tail sequences. And after that, we did the purification of our DNA by using the Ampure XP beads, and the concentration of our target gene was measured and recorded. We pulled our DNA to a desired ratio for sequencing, and after that we ligated and prepped our DNA by using the ligation sequencing kit protocol. In here we basically attach the specific adapter that will hold the DNA long enough in a flow cell for its nucleotide to be identified electronically in a real-time manner. The sequencing was performed by using the flow mean ion 107 flow cell on an instrument called mean ion MK1B for 2 hours, and we were able to generate more than 0.4 gigabyte of data with a quality score of 20 and a quality depth of more than 36,000. After the sequencing, then our raw sequence data was base coded and matrixed by using the Coupy software, and the alignment was done by using our Minimap 2 software. The variant calling was done by using the virus scan, and the annotation was done by using the ANOVAR. These are basically the analysis steps that were followed during the bioinformatics of our sample. The result of objective one, that was to test the performance of assay on DNA from both whole blood and dead blood spot, we were able to identify the mutation on a beta gene locus on both whole blood spot sample and dried blood spot samples. A total of 75 gene line mutations were identified, 38 were synonymous mutations, 25 were non-synonymous mutations, 4 were a loss of HBB initiation codon, and 2 were splice mutation located at exon 1, and in the bracket it shows the specific mutations that were identified at exon 1, and 6 were a stop gain mutation that were located at exon 2, and in the bracket it shows exactly what kind of mutations that were identified at exon 2. And the result for object 2, that was to compare the result of the mini ion DNA analysis test invasive zones of conventional screening methods, that is IF, HPLC, and Sanger sequencing. And from this step, from my left hand side, it shows the sample that were included in your study, the sample type, the cohort, both validation, the discovery cohort were included for this objective, and the methods that were used in conventional screening methods. So some of the sample we use Sanger sequencing and HPLC, a sample for dried blood spot, the conventional screening method that was used was serotic focusing, and sample from whole blood is a conventional screening method that was used was Sanger sequencing. And the result from conventional screening method as shown in the table. So as you can see from both conventional screening method and the lizard from the nanopost screening method are exactly the same, with a few exceptions in few samples. As you can see in sample 1, 4, 4, and 2, 4, 5, in nanopore we were able to detect two different mutations in the same gene locus. As you can see in sample 2, 4, 4, 5, for example, we're able to detect the triple fat X mutation, but also we're able to detect the root 7 valley mutations that cause sickle cell disease, and triple fat X mutations that cause the thalassemia mutation. And this table is an extension of all the samples that were performed for the objective number 2, that was to compare the results from conventional screen method and the results from nanopore sequencing method. Conclude, our sequencing result for sickle cell disease uses the mean ion instrument sequencing method were 100% same as those from Sanger sequencing method and other conventional screening methods, that is high performance liquid chromatography and isolated focusing. In addition, the long lean DNA sequencing method enabled the resolution of cases with unusual phenotype, which make up 1% of all children in Africa. But also the turnaround time of mean ion sequencing technology is actually shorter as compared to the conventional sequencing method. As we explained before, we were able to sequence a sample for only 2 hours, while other conventional sequencing method may take more than 24 hours. But also, as explained before, our instrument is very simple, easy to use, and you can use it anywhere. It doesn't need a comprehensive building for sequencing to be done. As long as you have a computer that have charged, then you can use your instrument everywhere. So this, we thought it would be a very good sequencing technology, especially in a limited resource countries. And finally, I would like to acknowledge the sickle cell disease patient and their families who gave us the permission to use their samples for this research. But also I would like to thank the staff of Department of Hematology and Blood Transfusion Sickle Cell Program, but also the staff from Tebeke Referral Hospital and the National Hospital. But also I would like to extend my gratitude to the funders who funded this research, the organization.